Okay, welcome back to more of Conquest of Sarpadia. And this part, probably can see if we can get through all of level 8. It is kind of a fairly long level. I mean, at least I have the shortcut, so it doesn't take as long to get there. Make sure you picked up the double magic beforehand. Kind of helps a little bit. Okay, so here is level 8. Volrath's Armory. And I believe this is... I'm trying to figure out which Castlevania game this originates in, actually. At least the one I know of is Super Castlevania, but I think you hear this in an earlier Castlevania game. In Super Castlevania is, I think, the Clock Tower. You know, if I can keep spamming the door, well, I'm just gonna do that, because you're gonna find a lot of Wizrobes in this place. Leave those bombs there full at this point. And yeah, you'll be fighting a couple more Gleeoks in this place. Well, at least it's not that hard that you have to look for another key, because unless you bought one. Probably could, because, you know, you got that one shop that's only 50 rupees per key. But you're not gonna need any more keys, because, you'll see why. Yeah, not a bad idea to light up some of these ruins, because yeah, you'll find a lot of Armo statues in this place. Actually, before going in there... I think you can go left in this room. Get some more bombs. I'll just get plenty of refills. You know, you do want to clear out this room because that should be your final heart piece. I don't think many of the heart pieces are that difficult to find. And you will get an item later on that will kind of help you further in case you're missing stuff. This room can be a little bit tricky to handle. No real safe spot in this room. Best bet here is actually kind of stay in between, like kind of in a half-tile position. You notice that the land molars really can't hit you if they're going up and down. You get anything for this room. I might just to make sure, might be just to let these guys respawn for refills later on. So instead of blocks, you pretty much most of these rooms are gonna have Armory statues. Well, at least I can just drill through. This door closes. Forgot about that. Thought it stayed open at the bottom there. Do get another key for this room. But there is something else in this room. Now, this next room can get a little bit messy. Best to hold these kind of half-tile positions. Especially with the water kind of helping you, you can, you know, they'll just teleport through and you can get free hits that way. This room is pretty much a dead end. It just takes you back. Oh, it takes you back to the start. Oh boy, so I'll probably have to go through the room with the dongos again. I probably should have gone through that left door first then. That was kind of odd. I kind of pushed through the stairs there. I didn't think you could get pushed over like that. This isn't an absolutely safe spot, but you know, it's better than nothing. So I can skip this, and yeah, I gotta take you guys out again. I guess if you're short on bombs. You need that extra heart slayer. So the whatever Femurf caves, yeah, so it looked like a tiny map, but there's a lot more to that place, and you need another item to actually fully explore that. And before going up, take a little detour to the side here. Snipe out the darkness on the door. Narrow passages. Uh, Now, you don't want to go up, because, you know, one, you've already been to that room, and it actually leads you back to the start. End up in that one dead-end room. So you do want to take a second look in this room. This next room can get kind of ugly, because you got this. A bunch of blue whiz robes. There's no easy strategy for this. Ideally, you actually want to attack vertically. You can see how both sides miss. This is for much later, so that's just an FYI, but you're going to be coming back to this passage later on. Now, in this room, it's actually just a little dead end, besides this passage, but you actually get a clue about a little trick. If you go back down these stairs, yeah, it doesn't take you back to the other room, it takes you to the magic key. And I think you have to get this to clear the level, unless you bought a key. Because I don't think there are enough keys in this level, otherwise. Yeah, so there is a little gimmick here that, you know, the passages don't always go back to... They don't go back and forth. I think the only other quest I've seen that is Randomizer. Track, you know, make you think there's just a little dead end. But you do have two reasons to go that way. One now and one later. Music a little bit, but I'm not gonna go out of the dungeon just to reset the music. Now that we got the detours out of the way, now we can head on up. And with the magic key, it's really no issue now. This next room you might want to move a little quickly in. easily can get stuck in this room. Since I, again, have the magic key, I can just go through all the locked doors. Keys anymore because I got the magic key already. This room, we got Patra. Sometimes you see, you think there's more than four fireballs flying on the screen here because they're trying to find just enough of an opening to attack here. There you go. Now going left leads back to that one room with all the blue wizards here. Not the best position for me. Takes a bit of practice to be able to time that right. This is not a very good setup to fight those guys. Yeah, so this is a hint to finding that magic key. And you're gonna see that trick again in level 9. So it may not hurt to just go back into the same staircase just to make sure it just goes back and forth. Okay, so there are stairs in this room, but this is the wrong way. This is the correct route. So just because you see a route doesn't mean you should take it right away. Just make sure there's not a trick behind it. Hopefully I can get some hearts back, because you're about to enter a really bad room coming up. Yep, you gotta throw more money away. So make sure you bring a little bit of excess with you. This next room is probably the bad one. Yeah, this room is gonna suck. see the hanging of vertical positions a lot better than a horizontal. That could have been much worse. Because by hanging vertical, I'm just gonna force him to miss. It doesn't help that you have all these statue shooters getting in the way. Yeah, you don't want to go attacking him horizontal, that's not a good idea. So if you attack vertically, you see, you know, they're all missing, they can't snipe or anything. So it gives me better chances to get through the room in one piece. I'm gonna need some health refills here. And I know I can get some towards the end, but get some now to try to help out a little bit. Even hide in the doorway because all the doors close behind you. And just get arrows ready for backup. I'm not feeling like getting back sent back to the start here. You have your sword with you. Yeah, kind of a complicated move to try to buffer myself to the door. But luckily, I don't think the door closes here. So you could always go back into this room as long as you don't kill off the Landmolas and just get more refills. I get as much damage from the doorway as I can. Two-headed fire will be off. If you're lucky enough, you'll take it out before it, without getting hit. Otherwise, you may have to use your, as long as you can get one of the heads out, actually, that's already better than nothing. Otherwise, I would just use my candle and bounce myself into the Gliok so I can attack it. But I think it is nerfed. It only does one heart base, at least. Alright, so finishing off level 8. Again, we'll be back in there later on. Okay, so now that I've got all 16 hearts, and got the whole Triforce, and before going to level 9, there's some little side dungeons you want to go into and pick up some goodies. So we'll be going into one of them in the next part. Alright, see you guys later.